so the next phase is called the load drill. So with the load drill, we're incorporating the stride into the delivery. With each one of these drills, we're going from the most simplistic movement, which was the half kneeling drill, where we're just working on the arm, and we're slowly increasing in complexity. So we're slowly adding more body parts. So now we're adding the stride. We still want to hit and execute all the things that we worked on, all the components we worked on in the last two drills, but now we're just incorporating the stride. The important thing when we add the stride is the hips have to stay low. We want to feel like we're sitting in a chair, and then really fight hard to not get pulled out of the back leg. The back leg is where our power is, okay? So we want to fight hard to stay loaded in that back leg as we move down the mound. So here's how the drill looks. Once again, we're going to start nice and wide, get our hips low, hands are separated, okay? So we're going to load the back leg, keep the hips low. See how my hips, I'm sitting backwards into my hips, not doing all the work with my knee. I want to use my glute hamstring to help move my body forward. So we're going to load our back leg, stay nice and low, create our stride, but as we move forward, stay back, and then rotate into landing. As we rotate, we're creating that same pec stretch position as the last few drills. From there, we're gonna rock back and throw the baseball. So that's the first segment, that's the breakdown phase. So once again, load the back leg, stay nice and low, stay back, rotate, land, make sure the arm's in the right position. Then we're gonna rock back and throw. Then when we put it all together, it becomes one movement. So here's how that looks. So load, stay back, rotate and throw. The whole purpose of this drill is to feel like you have a lot of weight in your back leg and your hips are nice and low. So stay back, rotate and throw.